3, 2, 1.
Welcome to Antimatters.
Hello, everyone. Let's jump straight in today. I got a package from Antantics, and I thought, you know what? Let's do an unboxing. As you know, I'm terrible at unboxing, so yeah, here it is. Real bloody fast. I made some funny noises when I was opening the box, though. Oh, I was very excited to get it open. As you can see, there's some ants in here, Polyrachis mitrata. They're not the only ones, though. Also, got a special delivery. Inside the little brown box is the brand new nest from Antantics, the bee back. I'm super excited to get my hands on one.
Genuine, real fucking deal.
Demonetized. I think it looks swick as hell. Straight out of the box, I was in love. It's a really tidy little nest though. And I love the little card inside as well, because until I got the little card, I'd been calling it the bird box. Anyway, let's get into the ants. I only ordered one colony, but a second tube must have fallen in as well. Oh no.
Thank you.
Let's have a look at what they are though. First up, we have... This is Camponotus levigatus, I believe. That's how you say it. I probably said that wrong, but isn't she beautiful? Look how shiny she is. Like, I think she's absolutely gorgeous. She's kind of like... Polyrachis rastellata, and then multiply its size by like 5 times, and oh, super shiny. I love this super glossy finish. I'm a huge fan of her. Fingers crossed I can get her ticking over. She seems really nice and happy though, really relaxed as well. I did leave, or they got left on the side for a few hours before I came home, so I think they chilled out a bit. Up next is the Polyrachis mitrata. I really love her, and when she came, she had one larvae, and I do love her red gaster, and with the eyes, it's a lot more, wow, kind of pops like a really dark, smoky ruby. Anyway, let's get into the bird back. I mean, bee back though.
I've been married a long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from?
Feedback though. I really love the finish on this. It's got bamboo, 3D printed filament. Feedback though. There's also two other colours, but I really like this one. It uses bamboo filament, which I'm a fan of. It's all nice and tidy and got bamboo. I really like the Antantics logo kind of stamped into the side. I tried a few tubes on the end, and I found that the Antantics tubes, they seem to work fine. Feedback though. Feedback though. Got bamboo. I think Antantics has done a really good job here of making their own nest look good for when you kind of get it. Because with the little card and with everything all... so nice and tidy. It was a real pleasure filming a few shots of the nest. Super happy with that. Anyway, let's get back to the ants. Let's have a look at the Polyrachis mitrata. As you can see, she's got some nice little spikes. I'd rate her about, well, 5.5. We're gonna round it up to 6 out of 10 on a spike scale. Hairs, she doesn't really have too many hairs. So, yeah. And kind of mouth parts, like beard. I don't want to sound harsh, because I haven't really had a proper look yet. But probably a 3. What does give her some bonus points, I'd say it gives her 5 bonus points, is that red gaster. So she actually ranks quite highly as a Polyrachis. Even though her spike rating isn't super high. And I think she's a good looking queen though, personally. On to the Campos. She's a beauty. It's a real pleasure filming such large ants, because normally I'm there filming tiny, tiny ants, and getting them to look nice is really tricky sometimes. But the big ants, oh, They know how to work it. She let me have a real close look. I really did like, on her back, she has three dots on either side where her wing muscles are. And these are ventricles, which basically they let the air in and out of her body sort of thing. But they have the big ones up there because when they fly, the muscles that work the wings, they use a very high amount of they need a very high metabolism there. So they're going to be burning for a lot more oxygen. But yeah, I thought that was an interesting little bit to see on her. She's a stunner though. She looks like a tank. A solid, glossy shield. Real beauty. I can't wait for her to lay some eggs. But I've kind of might have to wait a little bit because she may want to have a little rest just from the stress of travelling. I believe she'll produce eggs and everything though, year round. She is from the tropics, so she doesn't really need to hibernate. I really do enjoy seeing her in such detail though with the macro. To say thank you, I gave her a little bit of sugar snaps. She wasn't too interested at the time, but later on, I swear, I went back and it disappeared. Back to the nest. The nest consists of, well, four pieces. You've got the outer shell, the inner shell, and two plugs. And a lid, so five. And they all pop together really nicely. It all looks, like, beautiful to me. The white contrasts with the tan really well. The little tube holder, too, works a charm. I do believe, though, it might be a little bit big for this founding queen at the minute. Because, well, I had a sneaky suspicion that she was just gonna sit around in the tube. To try and lure her out, I did give her a little bit of food. Gave her a bit of mealworm and some sugar snaps. And I thought she was gonna pop out the tube and maybe have a little sip. But she decided, oh, not this time. I decided to have another good look at her. Ain't she a beauty? Again, she decided, you know what? I'm going to tease him by going up the tube. She got a little bit further this time and I saw her little antennas banging out the end. She could definitely smell there was food, but I don't think she had the confidence to venture out of the tube yet. I could see her there with her little larvae peeking out. And she's like, oh, there he is, he's watching. Do you know what? I'm going to turn around and bugger off back to the other end of the tube. Can't have him watching me eat. That'd be bad. So don't be shy. Another thing about it, which I've forgotten to mention, and I only got a little bit of footage about, was it has little feet as well. And these really do help reduce the amount of vibration that the nest kind of receives when you put it down and things like that. It also helps when you're pushing against it, like adding a tube with one hand while filming. It gives it a little bit of grip on the floor. So I've been using the nest for about 5 days and you may notice something has changed slightly. It turned out that I was looking in and I thought, oh, do you know what, my manica colony might appreciate the little bird box a little bit more. And I thought, yeah, I'm going to do it. They're going in. So I've unplugged the Polyrhachus queen and she's now in a tube again on her own. And I've put the manica in it, but they absolutely love it. And they look so good against the white insert. I'm super super happy with them in there. This colony previously had lived in a tube with a vented mesh cap like one of mine and they'd done mega good, but they were kind of done too good, so I could barely feed them and I hadn't cleaned them for over a month because I couldn't get in there because they've got about at least 10 to 12 workers I believe, and every time I go in they are straight out and they're so aggressive. They're wild girls. Anyway, I'm super happy with the little beadback. I think I'll definitely buy some more, to be honest. So, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Until next time, may all your ants live long and prosper. Have a fabulous week, and bye!